solar. So they've seen that for this. Okay? Thank you. Yes.
Of course.
Thank you.
Just so I want to reference the exhibit, you know what we're talking about. All right, good afternoon. Thank you for your patience. We started a little later, but the attorneys met, and I think understand had some fruitful discussions in terms of stipulating to parts of the record for me to review after today. Counsel, if you would just introduce yourself for the record, starting with counsel for the applicant.
Your Honor, the county, Mr. Sullivan, and I have discussed this matter at some length, and as I'm sure you're aware, we have not been idle. There has been document transmission back and forth for days now, and in a real effort on part of both counsel, and my compliments to counsel, in an effort to narrow the issues and present this to you in a final form so that you can then take it from there and fulfill your function, sir.
Yes, sir.
So having said that, I'll invite Mr. O'Sullivan to join me. I think he has a better grasp on the specifics of what we've done. But basically, the notion is that there are things that are beyond dispute, the ordinance, the staff reports, those things. They should all be properly in this record. There
yes,
are
sir.
Other items that are within the county's province, and they have them, but there's we are not confessing the veracity of these things, mail received from people. But they were received, and they were received in good faith, and they're part of the record. But we're not fessing up to the accuracy, factual accuracy of what's in there. So
yes,
having
sir.
Said all that, I'll turn it over to Mr. O'Sullivan.
Thank you.
Mr. Hearing Officer, my name is Rory O'Sullivan, and I'm here on behalf of the St. Charles County Department of Community Development. As Mr. Wallach has informed you, we were able to agree to a stipulation as to the introduction of certain exhibits. At the hearing, the pre-hearing conference on January 29th, 2018, you were kind enough to provide both parties with a copy of the record of evidence in this matter. It is the county's suggestion, and I believe stipulated to by the applicant, that that record come into evidence in before you today, be introduced and accepted, including these exhibits 1 through 6, which I can provide you with a copy of.
Are you referring to 1 through 6 on the list of proposed exhibits?
Yes, sir. So exhibit number 1 would be the November 6th, 2017 planning and zoning staff recommendation.
Let me ask you to pause for 1 second.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, gentlemen. I want to, just so we know we're on the same page, because there was a question that someone had asked from the audience earlier. We're here, my name is Don Cole. I'm the hearing officer, and this in essence is a mini trial. A hearing on this matter would ordinarily involve opening statements, presentation of evidence by counsel for the applicant, counsel for the county. Any objections or stipulations I would rule upon, and then closing statements, and then would be submitted to me. Now, I understood that counsel met and had fruitful conversations, it sounds like, in which they've agreed to stipulate to the evidence for me to consider after today. Is that a pretty fair summary of where we're at, gentlemen?
That is correct, Mr.
That's,
Hearing
that's
Officer.
That's correct,
okay.
Your Honor. 1 through 6, we agree with the, not only stipulate to the document, but to the contents.
Okay, so my understanding, there's no objection as to the admissibility of exhibits 1 through 6 on this, the county's proposed exhibit list. Is that correct?
Yes, that's yes, Mr. Hearing Officer, yes.
Right. Thank you. I'm going to have those admitted in the evidence. Anything else at this time?
Judge, that, or excuse me, Mr. Hearing Officer, that should be the close of the evidence in this case. There will be no further testimony or evidence from either side. As far as the parties are concerned, you have a complete record before you once you have received these exhibits 1 through 6.
If I'm understanding as well, so I'm clear, part 3 of that, I believe, was the certified copy of the bill plus the exhibits, which included the application itself.
Correct.
Public comments and questions, and then you've also provided the video recordings of both the November 15, 2017 public hearing and the December 4th, 2017 public hearing and the recommendations and the reports from the P&Z. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. With the caveat that the stipulate, my understanding of the stipulation is that that comes in and may be considered by you, but not as to the veracity of third-party statements made, you know, whether accurate or inaccurate.
Well, let's make sure we're clear on that.
Yes.
Are you addressing that to the collection of public comments, from third people who wanted to express themselves?
Staff comments, that does not apply.
Yeah, ordinarily what I would do on those is, I would assume there's nothing in there which would go to the evidentiary value. I'll consider them for what they are, which is public comment on how they envision the effect and problems and concerns, but not as to any hearsay discussion. Is that kind of what you gentlemen understood?
That's my understanding as well.
That's
fine.
We're basically blowing past the hearsay exception and the foundation.
That was.
Except the applicant is very must be very careful, and I think you recognize, and I think you've correctly stated it. It's fair to say, yes, Joe stood up and said such and such, period. There's no conclusion that such and such is scientifically or factually accurate, only that he said it.
I understand that. And that's my understanding. And they'll be considered for that purpose.
Yes, Mr.
Different than, you know, recommendations and other parts of the exhibit, which would be factual. Anything else, gentlemen? On your behalf, so I'm going to, when you get finished with that, then we're going to talk. I'm going to want both sides to submit proposed decisions, including findings of fact and conclusions of law. But did anything else to cover before we get there?
Yes, sir. It was covered in the earlier record and in the transcript. I just want to reassert it that we maintain our position, the jurisdictional argument we made earlier. We maintain that as we have throughout. And we maintain our tendering of compliance with the requirements.
Yes, sir.
That if granted, I think there are 15 of them. So
yeah, a jurisdictional argument. Nobody's waving that. You couldn't, and I couldn't. So I understand that. There is one other matter to add to the exhibit list. If there's no objections, I would like to add. Is that hearing officer exhibit AA, which is a transcript of our scheduling conference? Thank you. That we had in January. Is there any objection to the admission and inclusion of that exhibit in the record?
No, sir.
As far as applicants concerned, it's part of the record anyway.
It's
no objection to it.
Thank you. Thank you. That had to be admitted. All right. So we know that we've got the P&Z staff recommendation, the report, certified copy of the bill, and the exhibits, which are the copy of the ordinance, copy of the plan, and the video recordings of the two public hearings. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
All right. Anything further in terms of evidence to present today?
Nothing.
Not on behalf of the applicant, Your Honor.
Not on behalf of the department, Your Honor.
Okay. At this point, I'm going to declare the presentation of the evidence closed in front of me. I'm going to ask that the attorneys provide us with proposed findings of fact and conclusions of law, and let me check my calendar. It's pretty succinct, so it won't take you too long to get this transcript available to them, will it?
No, sir.
Okay. All right. I mean, you could have that within a few days to them.
Of course.
All right. That's fine, because I don't know, though. I never want to trust to my notes as to which numbers coincide. So we'll have that right away. And if we're looking at... Let's have them submitted on or before March 19th. That's a little over 2 weeks. That should have a chance for everybody to get a copy of the transcript. I know you were exchanging some records, and I appreciate counsel to getting those stipulations. And have those here, if you would, on March 19th. You can file them contemporaneously. I also have no objection. It's up to counsel if you want to file them ahead of time. You know, that doesn't usually happen, but...
It's basically a mutual filing.
Yes, but I have no objection to if anybody feels that they got them done early and want to get them in. Right. Otherwise, I'll look to have them in by the conclusion of the day on Monday, March 19th.
Thank you, sir.
All right, anything further for counsel?
It's all from the applicant.
Nothing, sir.
Anything for the county?
Nothing.
All right. Thank you. And the presentation of evidence is closed today. I'll await the receipt of the proposed decisions and then have a chance to review all the exhibits, which are extensive, including the hearing. And then I'll render our proposed decision, which goes to the county council, who makes the final choice. All right. Anything further, gentlemen?
No, sir.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Honor.